Hi, welcome to an Arduino step-by-step course by RoboJax. In this lecture, we are going to see how we can use this 4-digit 7-segment display based on the TM1637 chip. 4-digit 7-segment display, which is very common module with Arduino. This module is offered in two different types, smaller and larger. This is offered at 0.36 inch or at 0.56 inches. And both of these are exactly the same in terms of functionality. The only difference is that this has decimal point, which cannot be used at the moment, but the rest is exactly the same. The size is larger, and you will get it in red color or green color like this. And also there are blue and white color of this is available. The prices are almost the same. You can get them from eBay. You have to download and install the library because there are so many variation of libraries. I'll provide you the link from GitHub and also from my website robojax.com, the trusted version that works. The module has 4 pin, and the other side that you see 4 pin is, depending on your application, we can solder the header this side or this side. This usually ships without the header is soldered, so you have to solder it. And in this one, you have no option. It will be only on one side, but in this one, they offered in both sides, and I soldered them in both sides. And we have 4 pins, clock, CLK, DIO, data, and out, ground, and 5 volts. In this one, it has been written like that. But if I put this here, clock, data, and out, and ground and VCC have been swapped. I don't know why they did. This module is 65.7 millimeter. By 26.8 millimeter by 12.3 millimeters. The small one is 21.5 millimeter in terms of width. The length is 40.7 millimeter. The depth is 10 millimeter. And this is the wiring diagram for this TM1637 4-digit display module. I've drawn this circuit using FirstThing and some editing in Photoshop. From the bottom, if you see, this is connected to the ground. The second wire is the 5 volts. I've been connected to 5 volts of Arduino. This is the data I/O in out. This has been connected to pin 6. And this is a clock. This has been connected to pin 5. And this is the wiring diagram for the larger version, which has connected on both sides, and it has some text, and the decimal point looks below, so this is upright. And the wiring is a little different, and these ground and 5 volts have been swapped. From the bottom, this goes to 5 volts, the second one goes to the ground. The third one, this is data in out, have been connected to 6. Last pin is a clock, which have been connected to 5. This is the wiring for the small version. From the left side, this pin have been connected to ground. The second pin is 5 volts, have been connected with a red wire to 5 volts. The third wire is the data in out. This is the orange, have been connected to pin 6. And the yellow is the clock pin. This has been connected to pin 5. For this larger version, the data pin, the clock and data pin is the same, 5 and 6. Only the VCC and ground have been swapped. From the left side, red is connected to 5 volts, and the second pin is connected to the ground. The data is the orange to pin 6, and the clock is to pin 5. Let me explain the code. The first line includes Arduino.h. That's a header file which is included with Arduino IDE. You don't have to download or put anything in the library. But this TM16337display.h is a library that I will provide you the link. You have to download it and include it. Once you download in your computer, it will be a zip file. Like previous videos, click on Sketch, Include Library, Add Zip Library, and then point it to where you have saved the file. In this case, I give you an example of a zip file. Just select the zip and click Open. Once you do that, close this IDE and reopen it again, and the library will be working with examples and everything. This line defines pin 5 for the clock. We use CLK, that's exactly how it is printed on the module, and then pin 6 as data in out. And this is a test delay time that I will display all this information on the screen with this much delay. This is just for test purpose. All digits, this is because we have 4 digits, and for each digit we need a value to turn all the segments of this display. So FF means, and that's in terms of hex, that means all the segments are on. And this is when you test all the segments on, you just send this to that to this display. And 000 means blank. It will, this is now 0 and this has some value. 0 means blank. So for the blanks, we use another array. And here, using the class, we create an instance as an object. We call it display, and we pass these two clock pin and data in out pin. This is as if I type here 5 and type here 6 and pass it. Inside the setup, we set the brightness using display.setBrightness, and 0F is the maximum brightness of this. You can adjust it in case in some environment you need less brightness, especially in darker area. Every time you want to clear the screen from previous value, we use display.setSegment, and then we pass this blank, which we have defined above, I just shown you. This portion, the tree line, is for to display this 125. This false means there is no zero. If you want the zero to appear, we just type false, true. This tree means it has 3 digits, the length, and this one means start with 1. That's 0, that's 1. If you say 2, it will start from this point. And now this line prints 384 with the true. This true means put a 0 in front of it. That's why you see this true, but we don't worry about the number of digits and where it should start. And the next example, 22, with false, 2 digit, and we start 012 from the second digit we started it. And then this 0 means start from the third digit, 0123 from the 3, and the length is 1. And this one is start from the second, and this is start from the 1, and this is start from 0. And here, this is the example that is included. It does a lot of things which we don't have time to explain. You can look at this in order to understand it. Change and set this time, let's say for 20 seconds, and every time this runs, you will see and understand. For example, this is now changing the brightness of the LED. And this is the portion of the code that we are in. And then it will print the word done in E, and this is the last line that it runs. And after that, we have, it says while one. This while one is used whenever you want the loop to never end and stay here. This is a very good trick to keep the loop stopped. And here is a simple counter. If let's say you want to display the number from 0 up to 2000, and this is the loop, the for loop that goes from 0 to 2000, and I changes from 012 up to 2000, and we use display.showNumber this, and then I, that is decimal, we are printing it on the screen. So I is 0123 up to 2000. After that, here we wait 3000 milliseconds, 3 seconds, and then this is the countdown. We start I by 1700, and then as long as it is bigger than 0, this will continue. And here we are decrementing it. Here the I is being incremented and here I is being decremented, and it goes until it reaches zero and then stop seconds and continue with the rest of the code that I've just shown you. And here is the code that is running. It goes up to 2000. As you can see, you don't have to define anything. It automatically starts from this side. You don't need to mention the length. You don't need to mention the position. Automatically it goes. And now when it reaches 2000, we will go to the next loop, which will start countdown from 1700. So it waits for 5 seconds, 3 seconds here, and then 1700 started, and this is now count. This was how to use the TM1637. This is a very nice module. You can do so much with this. And many applications you can use it. Thank you for watching. Please make sure to subscribe by clicking at the subscribe button in here. Thank you. Thank you for watching the tutorial from RoboJax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And don't forget to subscribe so you get updates of my upcoming videos.